The city is asking for the public's help with moving forward on building a new fire station. CRI explains how the plans may affect your pockets. The city council is looking to increase Oskaloosa's franchise fee. We'll give you the latest. And improvements to the Lacey recreational complex are still ongoing. Stick around, we'll have an update.
From Oskaloosa's television news source, CRI Weekly News starts right now.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Jason Madison. The city council needs voter approval when it comes to increasing or issuing bonds for Oskaloosa's fire station. The current fire station is outdated and space is an issue. The future project would fix the department's current space needs and create the option for more room in the future if needed. The bonds for the $2.9 million renovation and construction project will show up on November's general election ballot. Oskaloosa City Council is working on ironing out issues with the fire department's more than 100-year-old structure, and the council needs the support from residents to move forward. To do away with its tight quarters, the council is suggesting using general obligation bonds to finance the construction. Those bonds come with debt that is spread out amongst Oskaloosa property owners.
The way that we've looked at the schedule for that debt is we've tried to make it so that it doesn't present a tax increase above what property taxpayers are paying today. And so as the city continues to pay off old debt, it is then replaced with this new debt. So in essence, it extends the debt life for a property taxpayer, but it doesn't lead to an additional increase in the taxes.
Debt service tax rate is what pays for the debt issued by the city. Schrock says the current debt service tax rate in Oskaloosa is averaging between $2.05 to $2.10 of a property's assessed value. Schrock says the council plans to keep it at that rate. For example, for an $8,000 property, the owner would pay about $39 each year.
Oskaloosa has a really low debt load compared to other communities, and we expect it to continue to be that way, even if this particular measure is passed by the voters, and even if the city and the voters approved additional debt. Oskaloosa still has a relatively low amount of debt compared to other neighboring cities or peer cities.
Schrock says it's healthy for cities to issue debt to accelerate infrastructure improvement projects, such as the new fire station. The department provides city and county services that are essential for everyday safety.
This is structured in a way that we're trying to not necessarily provide an additional burden to the taxpayers of Oskaloosa, but we want them to make sure that they understand how it does extend the life of the debt that's issued or that we're already paying on.
Residents will vote on the matter during the general election on November 4th. The franchise fee for Oskaloosa is one step closer to increasing by 2%. The city council passed the second reading of the fee increase on a 5-2 vote. The council is pursuing the franchise fee to increase to make up for potential losses in property taxes. A recent reform changing the classification of multi-apartment complexes could cause the city to lose up to $500,000 each year from 2017 to 2024. Increasing the franchise fee by 2% across the board would generate an additional $290,000 for the city. Remember, properties classified as commercial, residential, and public entities pay a 3% franchise fee, and properties classified as industry pay 1.5% franchise fee. The council is looking to increase the franchise fee by 2% across the board. That change will start in November if all three readings of the ordinance are approved. The council will vote on the third and final reading of the franchise fee increase on September 15th. Oskaloosa students can now take a walking bus to school every Wednesday. The school district kicked off the Blue Zones initiative this week. Elementary and middle school students can now walk in groups to get to school. CRI's Eduardo Zamaripa explains.
The Oskaloosa School District began Walk Wednesdays this morning. Every Wednesday through the end of October, the Oskaloosa Elementary and Middle School will participate in a walking bus.
We're real fortunate that we had the opportunity to have such a lovely morning to start with today. And hopefully this will model and encourage students to make healthier choices about exercise, having a good time with their friends, and just taking a walk on the bike trail that we're so fortunate to have here in Oskaloosa.
For the middle school, the students will walk to school from the YMCA, and for the elementary, the students will walk to school from Lacey.
This encourages them to make choices that are not just going to affect them in the short term, but this is a lifestyle choice that will be with them through adulthood.
On Wednesday, more than 30 families participated in the walking bus at Lacey. The spring walking school bus is expected to launch in late March and run through the end of May. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Eduardo Samarripa.
The Blue Zone's engagement lead, Miranda Cummings, says approximately 15 students participated in the walking bus from the YMCA to the middle school. Coming up next, Penn and Osky kicked off their seasons. We'll tell you how both teams fared as they get ready for week two. Work is still ongoing at the new community stadium at Lacey. The installment of a two-story permanent press box is being built and put in place for the more than $10 million project. Construction is entering its fourth year and the fourth phase, says William Penn University Athletic Director Greg Hafner. Phase one was the actual field turf and the home bleachers. Phase two was the track, and phase three was installing the visitors' bleachers and finishing off the locker rooms. Hafner says the construction weighs heavily on donations. The press box is being built slowly as the fall sports season is already picking up.
I think you'll see changes as the season goes on. This deal is supposed to come in the next week or so, so I believe they'll start putting the outer shell on the press box. And I think the entire project, interior and exterior, will be done by next fall.
Hafner says the permanent press box will add to the versatility of the new facility. Coaches and staff will soon be able to overlook both fields, the field turf to the east and the natural grass soccer field to the west. As construction continues, Hafner expects the stadium to be top-notch for Penn and the Oskaloosa School District.
It's just important for people to be patient, you know, during the process, because construction is sometimes a pain, and, you know, we found that out, but you know, we've always found out also that the end result is absolutely worth the wait.
Hafner says the construction of the press box will pick up. Once it's completed, phase five of the project will consist of paving current and future parking lots, along with installing a larger scoreboard. As unfinished business is being taken care of above the field, down on the turf, the Statesmen were laying their foundation for a redemption season. Last weekend, Penn kicked off its season hosting Bethel, Tennessee. With Coach Todd Hafner and the rest of the Navy in gold pumped, it was time to forget about last year's 5-6 season and start anew with a clean slate. Out of the gate, William Penn does something it's not known for, pass. Taylor Parsons goes play action and rolls right. Parsons fakes the D and the cameraman as he finds newcomer Jatavia Stewart streaking downfield. Stewart hauls in the long ball and dashes 74 yards to start the route. Fast forward to later in the first quarter, and Penn is on the move. Parsons flicks the ball out to senior slot back Sam Tweed, and the kid has speed. He darts 47 yards before being pushed out on Bethel's 13-yard line. Then just two plays later, senior fullback Evan Ressler caps off the 82-yard drive with a 1-yard score, doubling Penn's lead 14-0. With the Statesmen's backs against the wall, the Wildcats go for a 29-yard field goal, but number 13, Kashawn Cohen, comes up lucky with the block. The ball is recovered by Penn's Keegan Murphy with 5 minutes and 50 seconds left in the first. Now with the clock winding down, Parsons decides to keep the ball this time and shows his knee injury from last year is a thing of the past. He jets 48 yards for the TD, setting up the old swing gate 2-point conversion. With backup junior quarterback Tyler Hafner behind center, the play catches Bethel off guard. And why not slip and slide across the goal line to make it 22-0? Penn would go on to thump the visitors 52-13 for its first win of the season. Penn controlled the ball in all facets of the game, racking up 557 yards to Bethel's 181 yards. William Penn hits the road this weekend to face South Dakota in its home opener. That game is slated for 2 p.m. The Indians football squad did not start off its 2014 campaign on the right foot. Last week, Oskaloosa hit the road to take on Winterset in its season opener. Despite a strong showing by the defense, the Indians weren't able to hold on to its 14-8 lead in the fourth quarter, as Winterset came from behind to take the W in a nail-biter 15-14. Oskaloosa's defense showed flashes of improvement. Remember, last year's Indians allowed more than 30 points per game and only allowed less than 15 points only once. Now the Indians are getting ready to take on an old rival, Ottumwa. The Indians have not faced the Bulldogs since 1995, a game in which Oskaloosa lost 25-0. Coincidentally, a year later, the Indians won their first and only championship in football. Ottumwa leads the all-time series with 50 wins, 40 losses, and 2 ties. Oskaloosa will look to get its first win of the year tonight, September 5th, at Lacey. The game starts at 7 p.m. And that's the CRI Weekly News for today, September 5th, 2014. We know you have many choices for news, so from all of us at the Communication Research Institute of William Penn University, we thank you for choosing us as a local news source. Our next newscast is Friday, September 19th at 6:30, right here on MCG Channel 12. We'll leave you now with a look at the past week through photos provided by Osky News, our coverage partner.
Stay up to date on all the news happening in Oskaloosa by following CRI Weekly News online at www.critv.org, facebook.com/CRI Weekly News, and Twitter @CRI Oskaloosa.